10 and do. This is the non-instructional chess session. It's not a narrative. Just playing chess. Look at that one. Yep, positive. Not really sure what that bishop sacrifice was for. Why did they do that? Maybe they thought the queen was coming in to kind of suffocate the king with the support from the knight. Yeah, a bit strange. Excellent. Get to practice the supporting of the double pawns.
Thank you.
24 minutes. Let's keep going with this non-instructional session. This is that opening that I don't like, and I'm doing it different now. Back to my rook. Cheek on it, and it's got a white square bishop as well. Timing's wrong. They could have taken there, I would have lost the rook. And now it's still the timing's wrong. Maybe not, I might escape. Yeah, that was not good. But I'm happy with the way we're opening with this one now. It's not put me in that rubbish position that I'm usually in. But yeah, did the timing's wrong there. We'll have a look at that. You know, I thought they didn't see that. Have a look at that. Yeah, I'm very pleased with changing the opening of this one. I have to remember it. Yeah, because normally I'd go, oh yeah, let's go and get this pawn here type thing. And we get sort of caught up in that scenario here, and we're taking the knight off the board, and we're feeling comfortable that, you know, the king's not castle, and somehow they end up getting a half decent position and we kind of feel jammed in after it all. But this time we've changed it and just gone nice and simple. Castled, feeling really confident that the position is a lot better. But then we over-egged it. Where was it? We went here, then they trapped the rook, but we took the pawn. Then they brought the bishop here, brought the knight here. And then our next move, I thought, yeah, that's right, that was wrong. Yeah, because all they had to do was take. We take, and then we lose the rook. So we've done that slightly wrong. We shouldn't have done that just yet. Just simply take the... could take the rook, or it's saying take b7 here, but taking the rook is not going to hurt too much. So that's the move order. That my brain was getting a little bit excited that, wow, this is better. Yeah, so a simple thing of the move order, really. Get that out of the way. And that just felt a lot better, a lot smoother. Crisp. Yeah, I thought they didn't see that the knight was protecting this, you know. I'm thinking, why are they going to come here? Because the rook's going to be able to defend itself. And I did think a bit of the tunnel vision on coming for the pawn. Nice one. So that's the half hour of non-instructional chess.